अक्षा विरासिस बजा नयो तीर्था नामे पुरी जायो तारा दसे ज्ञान सिंधु तारी आहा हुई ते वंशा क्रोध वश्य कृपा सिंधु भयो हरे कृष्ण हरे ओम अज्ञानदेव राम रस
कृष्ण
वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय 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 श्री राम। बोला बढ़िया ओम अज्ञानदेव राम रस ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुर्मीदं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। वंशाकरोद्भवस्य कृपा सिन्धुभ्यो च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो सर्वप्रथम मेरे गुरुपाद
First, my obeisances
नित्य लीला
to my Gurupada
Vaishnava
Padma,
Vishnupad
Vila Pravistam Vishnupad Stutarashad, Srimad Bhaktivinoda Shilavaman Goswami Maharaj, and also to, just one sec, I think Gurudev was speaking something before, no? So first of all, my obeisances to my Guru Pada Padma, Nidhala Pravistam Vishnu Pada, Stotra Shata, Shishimad, Bhakti Vedanta, Shila Vamana Goswami Maharaj, into Nitalila, Pravishtam Vishnu Pada, Stotra Shata, Shishimad, Bhakti Vedanta, Shila Narayana Goswami Maharaj, to their lotus feet, which should take away all the fear, my obeisances to their lotus feet again and again. And also my obeisances to all them. So everyone, my obeisances and my also like welcome and my greetings. So we are reading some shlokas from the fifth chapter of Chaitanya Charitamrita. Which number shloka we were?
धर्म कर्म का कई संबंध है छोड़ कर भी चले जाते हैं। यहाँ से शुरू कितना शुरू नंबर था यह है।
So do you remember which number श्लोक we were reading?
पंचम आदिलीला पंचम परिच्छेद।
Fifth chapter आदिलीला। Let's read some shlokas, some like verses, and then I'll speak something in Hindi.
दशम श्लोके अर्थ कहिल विवर युग मन्नंतरे ঈশ্বরীর সবিনাদ নর নারায়ণ বৃষায় মান মা ভবন উপি তত্ত্ব না পায় কথ করে চৈতন্য আর সব অন্তে গ্রাতে তার সেবক গজমত্ত যিনি মদ মন্থ स्वरूप कृपा पाइनु जब वृंदावन में पधार जय जय नित्यानंद जय कृपा मय जहाँ हुई ते पाई रूप सनातन जहाँ हुई ते पाई रघुनाथ महाशय जहाँ हुई ते पाइनु स्वरूप महाशय सनातन कृपा पाइनु भक्तिर सिद्धांत स्वरूप कृपा पाइनु भक्ति रस प्रांत
Okay, we'll stop here. So I'll speak a little bit of Hindi, otherwise all goes to sleep. All you'll just be sleeping. Because I'm reading Bengali, in Bengali. So, like when we read the Bhagavatam, my desire was in the month of Purushottam to read the Chaitanya Charitamrita, but like only the verses, like read completely Chaitanya Charitamrita in this month of Purushottam, only the verses, I had this desire. So those who have the book, so I'm reading Bengali. I want to do this paran, this expression Gurudev is using. Paran means like, just like when you're reading the Bhagavatam. So in the same way, like continuously, the verses. So my desire was to, in this month of Purushottam, to just read only the verses of Chaitanya Charitamrita. Those who have the book can follow and can continue reading all the verses. This will be good. But you're not understanding everything what I'm saying in the Bengali verses. So I'll just tell you from the Chaitanya Charitamrita in Hindi now. So, 18th chapter of Chaitanya Charitamrita we were discussing. How Mahaprabhu, when he came to Vrindavan, seeing the beauty of Vrindavan, Mahaprabhu became absorbed in Bhav. Why? It was his own birthplace, isn't it, Vrindavan? Because Mahaprabhu is Krishna. But he is with this golden complexion. He took the kanti, complexion of Srimati Radhika, but he's the same person, same Krishna. That's why Mahaprabhu, when he saw Vrindavan, he was remembering everything, like remembering Vrindavan. And he was thinking, I left Vrindavana and I went to Mathura, then I went to Dwaraka, and then I went to Kurukshetra, and then again I came to Dwaraka, and then I came to Mathura, then again from after Mathura I came to. I crossed the river, the Jamuna River, and I had these amorous pastimes with gopis, then I went to transcendental worlds again. So Rupa Goswami explains that this was the order that Krishna did. Just like Gurudev said now, Vrindavana, then Mathura, then Dwaraka, then Kurukshetra, then again Dwaraka, he said, no, then again Mathura, like this, was the order of Krishna's pastimes, but in the Bhagavatam explains that from Vrindavana, Krishna went to Mathura, from Mathura to Dwaraka, and after that, after Dwaraka, Krishna killed all the demons. Then he married 16,108 queens. And he did so many pastimes with his family in Dwaraka, and then, like sons and daughters, and like this. And after that, Krishna did two leelas, which are called Indrajalik leela. What kind of leela? Indrajalik. Do you know what is Indrajalik? Means it's like something which is not true, like this illusion leela. Just like a magic trick or some illusion. So this is Indrajalik leela. It's not true, actually. Like some people. they chant some mantra, they get some perfection in some mantra, then they show something to you, like some artificial thing, which looks like it's true, but you think it's true, you think it's true. Have you seen the Swami Baba? I think Sai Baba? So Salagram was coming out of his mouth, okay? What's the name of the Babas? I don't understand if it's Swayam Baba or Swam Baba or Sai Baba, sorry. You can also listen, Gurudev will speak again. Look. So something which is not true, Indrajalik. You're just like making this trick in front of the people. It's not true. He'll speak his name now, look.
सिद्धि प्राप्ति करके आपके कुछ वस्तु दिखा देते हैं, नकली वस्तु दिखा देते हैं, आप उसको सच मानते हो. जैसे आप साईं बाबा के देखा है ना,
समी बाबा, संग्राम मुख से उनका, सॉरी आई डोंट नो इफ समी बाबा और साई बाबा, समी बाबा, आई एम नॉट श्योर द नेम ऑफ दिस पर्सन. सालग्राम वाज कमिंग आउट ऑफ हिज माउथ, ही यूज्ड टू,
सालग्राम किसी मुख से निकाल,
बट डू यू थिंक सालग्राम रियली कम्स फ्रॉम द माउथ ऑफ समवन, दिस इज ट्रू?
हेलो.
But he was doing that.
So,
this is called Indrajalik Leela. In Sanskrit, it's called like illusionist. Indrajalik Leela. It's like illusionist tricks. Makes illusion in your senses, like a magic trick. So, for example, imagine if you go in the summertime and you were like on the road. And you're driving, okay? And then 5 meters in front, it looks like there is some waves of fire. But when you're in the car, sorry, it's not. Okay, sorry. What happens like when you're going in the road and you're in the car, and then you look at the horizon. Then actually not, I told fire, I'm sorry, no. He said like the sun rays and the heat, they look in the horizon, when you look, looks like it's water, okay? The sun rays, this heat near the road, looks like it's water. So, but you continue walking in the, riding the car, and this water always like seems to be in front of you, like coming, but it never comes because some illusion in your sight.
Rasta itne tab gaya.
The road is so hot, then the sun's of rays, the sun is reflecting in the road. And it looks like there is some waves and water, but it's not true. So in the same way, so Maya creates these illusions, something which is not true. So Bhagavan Krishna,
भागवत के अनुसार कृष्ण,
अकॉर्डिंग टू भागवतम,
स्वधाम जाने के पहले,
बिफोर कृष्ण गोइंग टू हिज ओन अबोड, ही मैनिफेस्टेड टू लीलास इन दिस वर्ल्ड.
कौन लीला बताया?
व्हिच वंस?
मौसा लीला कहा जाता है. क्या लीला बताया?
मौसा लीला
और एक लीला है क्या?
एंड अनदर लीला,
महिषी हरण लीला.
Mahishi Haran Lila. So these two Leelas are called
Indrajalik
Leela. Making this illusion in people's minds, people's sights. So, Krishna's son, who?
Pradyumna.
And the son of Pradyumna is Aniruddha. And Aniruddha's son is
Vajranab.
So Vajranab, the great grandson of Krishna, for Krishna remembrance, he created many places in Vraj, like established many places. So once in Dwaraka, Krishna, he was there. Dwaraka is such a beautiful place that Maya can't enter Dwaraka, cannot enter Dwaraka, doesn't have any influence over Dwaraka. Because Dwaraka Puri is completely protected by the long arms of Krishna. So So, not even the curse of a Brahma, a Brahmana, cannot enter Dwaraka. Like any curse will not have effects there. Maybe somebody is cursed by a Brahmana, but this curse will not have any effects in Dwaraka Puri. Even this Brahma Saap, I think the curse of like a Brahmana, or like this great curses, like somebody very great gives you a curse, but this will not have effect in Dwaraka. For example, Narada Rishi, he made all the 10,000s of sons of Prajapati, Daksha Prajapati, become Babaji's, like renounced person. So Daksha Prajapati, he gave a curse to Narada. Ah, you made all my sons become sannyasi, now no one wants to marry. Or so the Prajapati, this Prajapati, progenitor, he told to Narada, hey Narada, Rishi, you'll not be able to stay anywhere for a time longer than the time for milking a cow. Like maybe 10 or 15 minutes, which takes to milk a cow. So you cannot stay longer in any, nowhere. In any universe, you cannot stay. Narada Rishi accepted the curse and said, oh, very nice. So now I have a pretext to go everywhere, just glorifying Lord. I'll be able to travel everywhere. Why? These great personalities, they travel here and there. They are always wandering in these worlds. Why? To benefit other people, actually. They don't have anything else to do. Like, they only want to benefit others. So the saints, the Bhagavatam explains in the shloka, the only duty of the Mahats, the great saints, is to inspire the hearts of the conditioned souls that they will do Bhagavat Bhajan. So, we are doing the Bhagavat Sapta in... Why? We don't want to take money or anything. The rich people actually in the month of Purushottam, they just want like money. Oh, how much you give me if I do Bhagavat Sapta like this? So they read the Bhagavatam only to get money, understand? But the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, no. Why do you do Bhagavat Sapta? So, yeah, Bhagavat Sapta, only to preach, so that people will have knowledge about Bhagavatam only. Because in Shastra explains, so the meaning is, look, the non-Vaishnavas should never listen to Harikatha from their mouth. Because if you listen, all these sinful activities will come to you. And they will. So, what will happen if you listen this katha from a non-Vaishnava?
Because
in the Padma Purana it explains. So the normal meaning of this loka about the milk and, you know, like this loka about the, you know, the snake and the, like, you should never listen to Harikatha from a non-Vaishnava because it's like drinking milk touched by the snake's mouth. Otherwise, all these sinful activities will come to you. The person will become free from sin, and he'll give all his sin to you and then go. That's why you should not listen to sinful activities from a non-Vaishnava. Putta means pure. So you should not listen to Harikatha from a non-Vaishnava. Just like the snake. If a snake touches someone's, like some milk, and you drink this milk, you'll die because this milk has the poison of a snake, you know? So if knowingly or unknowingly you take poison, you die. So in the same way, the glories of Bhagavatam Katha, it's like knowing or unknowingly, if you listen Bhagavat Katha, you'll be delivered. So in this context, we are speaking, what?
ये भागवत कथा जो है भगवान की कथा विशेषकर पुरुषोत्तम महीने में
सो भागवत कथा स्पेशली इन इज मैप ऑफ पुरुषोत्तम
अत्यंत ध्यान से
सो यू हैव टू लिसन विद सो मच केयरफुल लाइक केयर लाइक केयरफुली यू शुड लिसन दिस कथा
मैंने कहा था
यस्टरडे आई टोल्ड
अजामिल केवल अपने बेटे का नाम रख दिया
ही ओनली गिव हिज टू हिज सन दिस नेम नारायण And just by speaking this name, he went to Vaikuntha and became delivered. So imagine those who are chanting pure holy names. Which kind of destination God will give to them? Who can ascertain? Who can say? Only Bhagavan. So Ajamil gave it to his son which name?
Narayan. उस समय भगवान चार तो भेज दिया जाओ मेरे भक्त के संकट
then Bhagavan sent four messengers to protect Ajamil in such a bad moment so that's why actually three Jamadutas had come to take Ajamil and they were like binding him and taking him by force
इतने समय भगवान विष्णु के चार दूत आकर के खड़े हो गए
But you see that picture there in the wall you can see but these four messengers of Vishnu came and hey with chakra, gada, padma, all these things and they stopped the way of the Jamadutas and they said, where are you going? The Vishnudutas asked to Jamadutas. Then Vishnudutas asked to Vishnudutas, who are you? Where have you come from? Actually, the body of the Jamadutas are so big. They are very like tall and fat, big body, you know, the Jamadutas from the hell, from the messenger of Jamaraj. So they asked to Vishnudutas, who are you? Where have you come from? No, opposite. Vishnudutas asked to Jamadutas. Okay, I'll just come back to this because it was not clear, sorry. Okay, so four messengers of Vishnu came. You can see in that picture, they had Vishnu, Chakra, Gada, Padma, like this disc, all this lotus flower in their hands. So where are you going? Where have you come from? Tell me first. So Vishnudutas asked, where have you come from? Who are you? Like, their body was very big. The Jamadutta's body was very big body. Jamadutta, very big and fat and tall. So the Vishnudutas told to them, where have you come from? Then they said, We came from Prabhu Jamaraj. We came from him. Why? What's your job? Why did you come here? Why? Oh, then they said, you know, this Ajamil? He'll give up his body and we'll take him. We'll take him. This is our duty. So this is my duty to bring them, the persons to Jamaraj. Then the Vishnudutas told, foolish! Get out of here. You see what is in my hand? Vishnudutas asked. I have a chakra just like Vishnu. Otherwise, I would like roll my disc, like I would swirl, like move my disc and all you die like this. Then the Jamadutas, they were afraid. And they said, Prabhu, why are you saying this? Ajamil is such a sinner person. Why are you saying this? Vishnudutta said, We also know, but see, once, if anyhow you chant holy names of God, the holy names of God, then he's not qualified to go to Jamaraj, to Jamaloka. Understand? Anyhow, if you chant holy names of God, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. Sanketam parihastam stovam heloram evava Vaikuntha nama grahanam asagaram vidurti. विष्णुदत्त ने कहा हमारे पास इतने समय नहीं है.
विष्णुदत्त said we don't have so much time. Go.
प्रभु के पास जाकर के
go to your prabhu, to your master and tell him the meaning of this shloka. Sorry, listen from him the meaning of this shloka. Vishnudutta said. So, Jamadutta said, he did so much sinful activities all his life. Then Vishnudutta said, hey, and what?
Like,
and in the time of death, he changed the name of Narayan or not? Yes. So all his sins were destroyed. Everything was is destroyed. You see what is in my hands? Vishnudutta said. You see this chakra in my hand? You see, very careful. So don't come one step closer. Otherwise, you know, you see this chakra? Anyone, if in the time of the death, if once, one time they chant the holy names of God, maybe it's pure name or not. Even if the name of, like for example, if you gave the name to your daughter of Radha, or Krishna, or Vishnu, a name to your son. So if once you chant holy names of God, you go to Bhagavad Dham. You not go to Jamlok. So Vishnudutta told, if you want to listen more about this, go to your master Jamaraj and ask him. Ask him. But Jamin, he was listening to this conversation. You know, this conversation between Jamadutas and Vishnudutas, he was listening to this. So this is Satsang, Association of Sadhu. What is Satsang, Association of Sadhu? Satsanga is where Bhagavad Katha is like somebody speaking about God. Oh, Maharaj, I'm not understanding, Maharaj. Okay, so let's make you understand again 10 times. Like, let's try to make you understand one more time, 10 times. You should understand very nicely. Very well, like you should understand nicely, like completely, you know. So this Katha is in the Bhagavatam, very beautiful. If once you chant holy names of Vishnu, you not go to Jamalok. You'll go to Bhagavad Dham, the abode of Lord. The Jamadutta said, but the rules we follow is that the persons who do everything bad, like evil, like do sins, those who take some other people's wealth, like wealth, like those who take the money of other people, we have to like punish them like this. And then, so Vishnudutta told to Jamadutta, okay, any doubt you have, any question, go to your master Jamaraj and ask him. And then they made these three Jamadutas go away. So the three Jamadutas, they were running away from the Vishnudutas, and they came back to Jamaraj, and they were like this. How do you say in English? I forgot. They were like this. Like this, like without breath, like this, because they were running, afraid that the Vishnu chakra would hit them, like would you know, touch them. So they came very running quickly to Jamaraj. Jamaraj asked them, what happened? Why you're so tired? Like why you're like running like without breath, like this, panting, no, in English, I think. So then they said, oh, you don't know, a gasping, I think, no? So Jamaraj, actually, he knows everything because he's one of the 12 Mahajans, you know? Yeah, painting. They were painting. This is an English word. So Jamaraj actually knew he was just doing Leela for the benefit of the people of the world, you know? Because Jamaraj knows everything. He's one of the Mahajans. So he asked, why are you panting like this? Like, tell me. Then they said, okay, we'll tell. Then Jamaraj said, tell me quickly, what happened? Then the Jamadutta said, oh, today we saw something like amazing, like we never saw before in our whole lives. Because of your, according to your instructions, we went to take that soul. a jamil for you. Because in the Bhagavatam, Shastra explains that those who are great sinners, Mahapapi, the Jamaduts, the Jamadutas, just like a collar, you know, like the dog. You take your dog with a collar, you put on the neck, you bind a collar in the neck of the dog, like this collar, I think they call it. No, how is it? Lace? I don't know. So the Jamadutas, they also do that in the persons, the people. They put this rope on their neck and they drag them and beating them so much like this. Okay? So... One second. And then... And they beat people so much. The Bhagavatam explains. In the third canto, I think third, he said. So in 1 second, they drag the persons. Yeah, collar. Okay, so they take the person just like a leash or a collar, like binding them with a rope on the neck. The Jamadutas, and they beat so much on the people, and they drag them like in 1 second. They very quickly they go with Yojan is a measurement, like I think 13 kilometers. So Gurudev said in 1 second how many Yojans they walk, like means they drag them very quickly. They have to they walk a great distance, and on a hot sand, like a so hot sand, they have to walk. But people cannot walk, but then the Jamadutas they beat the people so much with like wipes, wipes. So the two Jamadutas they bind you in the neck with a rope and like dragging you, and in the back also other Jamadutas beating you. You know, because you did three kinds of karma, with bad karma, with your body, with your mind, and with your words, right? So one Jamaduta would already be enough, isn't it? But, so the Bhagavatam explains how people are so much beaten. They are beat. So the people, Jamadutas, they beat the people so much, so the people are beat up by Jamadutas, and then they come to Jamaraj and they decide. Jamaraj decide where this person will go to the hell or for how long. This Naraka or that Naraka. There are Kumbhipak Naraka, many kinds of Naraka. Many kinds of Naraka. The Bhagavatam explains. There are you know how many kinds of Naraka? 8,400,000 kinds of hells. Like in some they put some like a boiling oil in your mouth, and then you're like trembling because it's you suffer so much. Maybe they make some pakora of you. They like throw you in the boiling oil, but you don't die. Your body, you feel so much pain. So they beat with the whip. With the whip. They beat you, and then okay, then they'll judge you, Jamaraj, and there are many kinds of hells. Okay, Asipat Naraka, one kind, Kumbhipak Naraka, another kind. So many kinds of Narakas. Bhagavata explains. So there are 8,400,000 kinds of hell. So big, the hellish planets. Some they put the boiling oil inside the throats, down your throats, and then you're trembling and crying for help. Some they throw you in the boiling oil and they make a pakora of you, but you don't die. You just feel so much pain in your body, you know, you suffer. Oh, if the person would die, you can say, oh, but this person, he was burnt to ashes. Like when somebody dies, we do the cremation, we burn the body. So how can this person go to hell because his body is over, we burned his body? You can ask, But the Bhagavata explains what happens. When you give up your body, the soul goes out from your body. Because the body stays here, right? The five element body. But inside of your body, there is another body which is called the subtle body. Sukshma Sharir. So they will give one kind of body to you that covers your subtle body, which is called Jatanamai Sharir. Which kind of body? After the death, yes, after the death. Okay, now you have your gross body, yes? Okay, but inside your gross body, there is a subtle body. And inside the subtle body, there's Atma Sarir, the soul. But when the normal karmi people, they die, what happens? Okay, the gross body will stay here, okay, and then we'll burn his body in the cremation place, like the crematorium. But God gives one, like, it's one kind of material body called the Jatanamai Sarir, and then you feel so much suffering in this body. So inside of the Jatanamai Sarir is the Sukshma Sarir, subtle body. And inside the subtle body, the Atma is there, Atma Sarir. So many people say, okay, after I die, they'll burn my body. How Jama Maharaj will take my body? This is all useless talk. This is not true. What is this? Hell, everything. No, but the Bhagavata and the Shastra have evidence. How this Jatanamai Sharir is given to you, this kind of body. They will bind you with the neck, with a rope. And the Jamadutta, they will beat you so much. They'll beat up you. Like, they'll beat you like so much. They will beat you so much. And you cannot walk. And then they'll put, there's a, this like a nails, you know, nail, like a iron thing, you know, very sharp. And then they'll put you to walk on these like nails, and then and the nail is so hot, like, and you have to walk, but you cannot walk, and your feet is like so much pain, like you cannot. But they drag you, over these nails, blazing heat, hot. So the Jamadutas told, you told us to go like you'd give us our job to go every day in different place. Okay, I'll tell you one story. It's not. So there was a Panditji. So there was a Panditji, he used to check the birth charts of people. So one person came to him, a Sergi, like a Sergi means like wealthy person came. A rich person came. So this man who was rich came to this Panditji, so a person who checks birth charts, like a Brahmana who does this also astrological duties. And he came to ask this Panditji what was the proper time for the wedding ceremony of his son. Okay? Okay, so the Panditji told, and the Sejji, the rich man, left. And then after this, another man came. But seeing this other man, the Panditji became afraid.
Huh?
How you came here? 15 years ago, you died. You died 15 years ago. I remember you dying. You died. Even I burned your body in the crematorium. How did you come here? After 15 years, then this man said, listen, you are my great friends, good friends, so I'll tell you. Yes, we were friends for a long time. This is true. So 15 years ago, I died for some reason, any reason, and you really burnt my body. This is true. I'll tell you what happened. Who am I? Okay, who are you? Tell me. I am a Jamadut. He was so afraid. Oh, did you come to take me? No, you're my friend. You still have more light time to live, don't worry. So why did you come here? Then this Jamaduta told, messenger of Jamaraj. Jamaraj gave me a list, because every day Jamaraj gives me a list. Just like in the train, they have the list of the passengers. Who can sit in which station, the list of the passengers of the train. They have list, isn't it? There's all according to the reservation, the train tickets. Isn't it? Like, for example, one person will go to the train until Mathura, until Agra. There's a chart according to the passengers and where they will come inside the train and when they also leave the train. So he told, I am a Jamaduta. Jamaharaj gave me a chart, like a list. And he told me, go to that village and this person is about to die and bring him. Bring his soul here. So like I told, Sukshma Sharir, Atma Sharir and this Jatanamai Sharir have to bring. Many people don't believe in this. Many people don't believe. But there is, yes, the Jatanamai Sharir, the Shastra explains. But who will die? Then, okay, I'll tell you. You see the Sergi, this rich man who just came. This Sergi, this rich man, he will die. The Jamaduta told to the Brahmana, to the Panditji, this person who just came here before me, he will die. He only has more 2 or 4 minutes of life. So I thought, okay, I'll meet some friend before that. And then you just were also with the Sergi just now, you just met him. So listen how beautiful the Jamaduta is speaking. Jamaduta is saying, who is saying? Who? The Jamaduta is saying, okay. He's saying, look. The Sergi, this rich man, was in the list of the people I had to take. Like 10 o'clock, 15 minutes, seconds, he will die. Everything's written, exactly time I have to take the soul of each person, like even the exact minutes, exact seconds, You know what they do today? Okay, what happens? So, like the Jamaduta Maharaj gives a list with the exact time that each person will die, and the Jamadutas have to take their soul. So, what happens is like nowadays in the hospitals, they have these artificial equipment, like ventilator machine, that they artificially keep the body. Even maybe the person has already died, but maybe they are like doing this forceful breath. So that like the body is like, it looks like it's breathing, but actually it's a machine which is making the body breath, take oxygen like this. So sometimes even the soul already left, but they're like keeping the body alive artificially. And what happens, you can see that this person who is in this kind of state, they don't speak, like they don't interact anymore. Those who work in the hospital, they know. Actually, they make these things only to get people's money. They do these things of like keeping people alive with these kinds of machines just to take people's money. Is the sound okay? The translation and also Gurudev's sound? So, who is saying? I just came back a little bit. Jamaduta is saying. The Jamaduta is saying. Look. I know that the rich man was in the list of Jamaharaj. Like 10 o'clock, these minutes, this second, like exact time that he will die, it is written in the list. So nowadays they keep the people in the ventilator, but then maybe actually the person already died. So they're forcefully, the scientists, they keep the doctors, they just like make the heart move by equipment. You see the speaking, but so actually these things you can ask those who work in the hospital. They're just
लाखों करोड़ रुपए धंधा कर लेता है, जिसके पास पैसा है ना, कहते हैं इसको, और आपको तीन चार डॉक्टर आकर के आपको बताएंगे बस इसको वेंटिलेटर में रखो, अरे ये मर जाएगा, इसको बचाने के लिए पैसा तुम्हारे पास है, पैसा तुम्हारे क्या काम में जाएगा, ये स्पेशलिस्ट वो स्पेशलिस्ट, तीन चार डॉक्टर आकर के इतने आपको कहेंगे ना, आप कहेंगे हाँ 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 वेंटिलेटर, और उसके चार्ज कितना होगा, अरे एक एक दिन है 50 लाख 50 हजार में कितने लग लेंगे।
सो व्हाट दे डू आई टेल यू, he's saying like this, what they do this business only to get people's money. So like the person is dying and then they, the doctors, they, so you'll say, okay, okay, my, this person will die. But the doctors say, no, no, but you, why, what will you do with all this money? You have to spend this money to, for this person. You have to use this money for this person like this. So like three doctors come and try to convince you. Of course, you have to keep him alive. You have to, maybe, you know, you have, you cannot let him die like this. So they tell you, and then they like force, they make your mind up, like they make up your mind so that you agree with them. Then you do this, like keeping the person alive in these equipments like this. But actually you see then how much is the bill of the hospital for one day? It's how much? 50,000 rupees, I think. So these doctors, they do this to get the money. So the state doctors will come to you and they will make up your mind. Oh, ventilator, he'll die. You have the money to save him. You have the money to save him. Why you not, why you, what do you do with this money? So like these three, four doctors, they make up your mind, they'll tell you so many things. Then you're like, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. You'll just agree with them. And how much is the charge of the hospital for one day? 50 lakh rupees. 500,000 rupees, yes? I think. Okay, so much rupees, so much rupees. So, no, 50 lakhs, I think is, what, 5 million rupees? I don't know, sorry, so much rupees. Oh, so they are making your heart work just forcefully. Somebody told me, I never saw this.
और उसको कि क्या करते हैं उसे पैसा लगा लगा
दे, एंड द पीपल दे स्पेंड द मनी लाइक दिस बिकॉज़ एसी रूम एंड एवरीथिंग,
डॉक्टर तीन बार आते
हैं, सो द डॉक्टर कम्स 3 टाइम्स अ डे, बट एक्चुअली द सोल इज नॉट देयर इवन एनीमोर, द सोल ऑलरेडी लेफ्ट इन दिस कंडीशंस,
थोड़ी समय तक रहा था और इसके बाद
ओके द सोल वाज देयर फॉर अ लिटिल बिट टाइम एंड देन द सोल लेफ्ट, बट नाउ देयर इज द साइंटिस्ट द मेडिसिंस जस्ट टू गेट मनी दे डू दिस थिंग्स, they put these machines and then your heart is forcefully working like this,
baat to kare baad mein nahi kare,
the person doesn't even speak anymore, just from far you show, oh, this is the person, ah, his heart is working, yes, his heart is working, but then all your money, everything you have, you just sell to maintain this person like that like that, in this condition of ventilators, like this, artificial. So this is true. I'm not lying with this story. Long time ago, I read this story in a magazine. So the Jamaduta told, this Sergi, this rich man will die soon. So my job is to, I have a list of people in this area I have to take, Jamaharaj gave me. So every day, Jamaharaj gives me a list to which, every day, which person I have to get. 24 hours per day, every day, there's a list of which person I have to take. Okay. This person will die like 10 o'clock. Sorry, Gurudev said exactly the timing, minutes and seconds. I couldn't check. Sorry. So, exact time. And then? So, he asked, oh, my friend, tell me then, how did you become a Jamaduta? Tell me a little bit about becoming a Jamaduta. Then he said, look, those persons who 100 times they go to the Jamalai, to the hell, after making sinful activities, then they come out from Jamalai, from hell, then they do sin and already they come back 100 times. So they get this job of being Jamadutas, Jamaduta job. They get the position of Jamadutas. So their position is to take people. like policeman who is taking someone like this. But those who beats the persons in the hell, those who for thousands of times, thousands times, like 10 times more, they have come out and in from hell. They go in and out from hell 100 times. They come and go 100 times. 1,000 times, sorry, 1,000. So 1,000 times. So they came to hell, they suffered, then they came out, they did some more sins, then they ended, they come back. Do you understand what I'm saying? So these people who come in back 1,000 times, they have this job to be of beating other people in hell. So they have to do this job for a certain amount of time, okay? So he told, so I got this job, what can I do?
बोले अच्छा ये सचमुच मुझे एक बार दिखा दोगे क्या बोले जीवित अवस्था में तो कोई देख नहीं पाते हैं
can you show me then the pandit ji said ask to go to see and then Jamaduta said you cannot go there living like in your, if you are alive then pandit ji said please ask Jam Maharaj because is this really true that the hell exists that the people are suffering there I want to see So his friend Jamaduta said, okay, now it's time, exact time, I have to take his soul exactly now, because now is the time. So I'll go to hell, ask to Jamaraj, then I'll tell you. So in exactly, he had a watch. So, in exact like 10 o'clock, that exactly minutes and exactly seconds, that same Sergi, rich man who was just a little bit time before he was with the Pandit ji to see the proper time to marry his son.
So,
so I think it was like 10:55 the time that person was about to die. So,
it or 3 seconds. Samachar aa gaya kya? Wo Seth ji. Bole theek hai. Dekho abhi to mera samay ho gaya.
So the Jamaduta said, okay.
Ho gaya. Abhi 3 seconds raha gaya. Main ja raha hu.
So now is the time I have to take his soul.
Isko pahuncha karke phir tumhare paas aa jaunga. Acha. Bhai bilkul theek haath mein ghadi rakha. 10:55
So 10:55 and 3 seconds. This was the time he got this news. He even checked in the watch, and it was really true that exactly that time the Sergi, the rich man, and you see this rich man, he was just there after a little bit, some minutes before to check the proper time for his son to get married, isn't it?
So.
So the Jamaduta told, don't tell anyone. The Jamaduta told this man, don't tell anyone. Don't tell anyone.
Jamaduta ठीक बोला, जो आया थे हमारे पास. अच्छा. So उन्होंने जाकर के जमदूत के बोला. जमदूत ने जम महाराज के बोला.
So the Jamaduta told the Jam Maharaj.
Maharaj.
After now he went to hell and asked, Maharaj, my friend wants to come alive to the hell. Just to see. He wants to see what is going on here or not. Jam Maharaj said, look, this is not the rule here. This rule doesn't exist that any person come here alive. But, okay, I can give some special permission because you're asking. The person, so Jamaduta was a little bit dear to Jam Maharaj, so he said, okay, bring him to show. So he came back the next day, said, my friend, okay, come with me. He told, oh, Pandit ji, my friend, come with me. So he went, and he saw that gigantic area, thousands of hectares of space, such a huge place. There was oil boiling and people were being thrown in the, and people, they were exclaiming, like yelling, everybody yelling, like this, and crying. So this Pandit ji said, I cannot stay here, I want to cry so much, this is so sad.
So साक्षात उनके ससुर में ले गए
एंड ही वाज देयर इन हिज ओन बॉडी
देखा इतने विशाल जम एरिया है हजारों हेक्टर जगह
सो इट वाज अ जिगेंटिक एरिया
कहां पर तेल खल रहे हैं
देयर वाज ऑयल बॉइलिंग एंड पीपल वर बीइंग थ्रोन people are being beaten up everybody
wo bole bhai ye dekh kar ke mera to rona
aa gaya main rah nahi paya he said I cannot stay here
aur itne gandh
such bad smell also from the people and
bare tab aa gaye wo bole bhai mitra maham yahan par
then he said oh my friend I want to go full of Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai This is true. The story is true. Some people say, oh, I'm doing sinful activities. Who is watching? Who is watching my sinful activities? God is seeing everything. Because the CCTV, the surveillance camera is on everyone. You are under surveillance every time, all the time. So who is writing? His name is? Chitragupta. In a hidden way, he's taking all your pictures. Everything you do, you cannot see him,
but
so like this, the clerk that Jamadut Maharaj has, this is his job day and night.
एक चित्र गुप्त नहीं, एक के थर्ड काम, हजारों उसमें है सब काम.
Actually, there is not only one Chitragupta, there are thousands and thousands, but their names is same. Like Jamadutta, Jamadutta is a title, you know, there are so many Jamadutas. So Chitragupta also, there are so many thousands and millions of, so many thousands of Jamadutas and Chitragupta also. They write everything you do, and if you say, oh, I didn't do that, then they'll show a picture to you.
जब आप झूठ बोलोगे
सो इफ यू लाई दे आल्सो बीट यू
पुलिस के पास झूठ बोलने
नो सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू लाई टू द पुलिस दे विल बीट यू बट इफ यू टेल द ट्रुथ इट्स बेटर यू नो फॉर द पुलिस
इसके नाम है सो
दिस नेम इज चित्रगुप्ता फर्स्ट आई थॉट दैट
शास्त्र में कहते नहीं अनेको
चित्रगुप्ता देयर वाज ओनली वन चित्रगुप्ता बट एक्चुअली शास्त्र एक्सप्लेन्स दैट चित्रगुप्ता इज अ टाइटल It's like a title, so there are many Chitraguptas. So, okay, I was saying that. Why I was saying all this? Do you remember what I was speaking about?
अजामिल के कथा
जो Oh yeah, about अजामिल.
अजामिल
के कथा जो Yes, अजामिल.
इसलिए कह रहे हैं जाओ तुम्हारे अपने हैं विष्णुदूत ने कहा
So the विष्णुदूत said to the जमादूतस
प्रभु के पास जाकर और बाकी सुन
लो Okay, go to the to your प्रभु to your master and ask more about this.
So
जमादूतस told Oh, we saw to the जमाहाराज We saw these people with a broad forehead, long arms, very beautiful. Then Jamaharaj was happy and told, Oh, my messengers, Duton, you are so fortunate because you actually had today the darshan of the messengers of my master, of Vishnu, Vishnu Dut. And today I'll tell you one thing, to whom you have to go and to whom you should not go to. Okay, I give you always the list of those who are dying, but you have to see carefully. If once in the time of death, chant holy names of God, you should not go to these people. So Swayam Bhagavan Jam Maharaj, He told this shloka.
क्या श्लोक बताया?
Which shloka?
श्लोक क्या बताया?
What is this shloka?
कुछ तो याद ही नहीं रहा.
You don't remember anything. Cannot keep anything, huh?
भक्ति भगवत नाम गुणाध्यम जो एक बार
If once you chant उसके बाद जाना. So you have to go to those who not even once chant holy names. But if someone once chants holy names, don't go to them.
जो मन के तरह भगवान
In their minds, those who think about God in their minds. Those who, with their body, they worshipped God.
ज्ञान भक्ति बनो ज्ञान भक्ति भगवत नाम गुण अध्ययन चेतन स्मृति मन के द्वारा कोई एक बार भगवान के चिंतन नहीं करते उसके पास जाना
सो यू हैव टू गो टू देम
करते उसके पास बिल्कुल नहीं
बट दोस हु चिंत ऑफ गॉड अबाउट गॉड नेवर गो टू देम
भगवत नाम गुण अध्ययन चेतन स्मृति तच्चरणारविंदम तानेव अधमो अकृतो विष्णु कृतवान वो अधम व्यक्ति जो ऐसे भगवान
दैट फॉलन पर्सन हु डजंट चेंट होली नेम्स हु डजंट थिंक अबाउट गॉड
अकृतो विष्णु कृतवान
Akrita Vishnu Krita. Those who don't do things for Vishnu. Vishnu Karja. Krita. What is the meaning? Vishnu Chakravati Pada. Those who don't follow Ekadashi. You have to go to them. Bring them here to hell. Those who follow Ekadashi Vrat. So this is the glory of Ekadashi. Those who follow Ekadashi, who follow Ramnabami, Gaura, Jayanti, like the Mahaprabhu, Krishna Janmashtami, all these activities of Vishnu, the festivals, don't go to them. So everybody should memorize this shloka, should memorize this shloka.
Chetana smrti tat charanarvindam, tane adhyam asato akrito Vishnu kritvan.
So beautiful.
श्रीमद् भागवत का अजामिल के पक्षण में
देखो सो श्रीमद् भागवत 6 कैंटो स्टोरी ऑफ अजामिल
भंडार में पाउस में लिखा देखो उसमें जिहान और भक्ति है कि नहीं है
जिहान और भक्ति इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द श्लोक
नाम गुण अध्ययन चेतन स्मृति तत् चरणारविंद तानम अनु अधम अकृतो विष्णु कृत्वा उनके लिए एक बार भी भगवान के नाम कर लेते हैं वो कभी नहीं जाए अरे अजामिल तो अपने बेटा के नाम क्या रखा
अजामिल गिव टू हिज सन द नेम नारायण
मृत्यु के समय नारायण नाम जप देखो नारायण नारायण मुझे रक्षा करो
सो इन द टाइम ऑफ डेथ ही सेइंग नारायण नारायण प्लीज प्रोटेक्ट मी
कहा जाता है नामाभास कहा जाता है किंतु इसमें ये एक शर्त भी लगा दिया
सो लाइक दिस नामाभास बट देयर इज सम कंडीशन इफ यू डू ऑफेंस एंड चेंट होली नेम्स देन विल बी
और भी
You get even more punishments. Because many people think, oh, if I chant holy names, all my sins will be destroyed. So I'll just chant holy names and continue doing the simple activities. So this is called Nam Boli Papa Budi. No, this is one kind of the 10 kinds of offenses. Means if you chant holy names with the strength, you do simple activities in the strength of the chanting holy names. Like the business people, they, for example, they get money, they earn money. This happens so much nowadays. So they take the
ration card, chawal.
How much is the rice? 3 rupees the kilo of rice.
3 rupees chawal.
3 rupees.
So, और आटा के साथ गेहूं के साथ मिला करके धीरे-धीरे उसको बेच देते हैं और आटा कितने किलो हो गया 20 रुपया किलो चावल के जो आटा मैंने पीस करके ना उसे एक साथ में मिला दिया कौन पकड़ पाएंगे हाँ समझो एक मन
ओके
गेहूं के साथ यदि 10 किलो
इफ यू पुट
5 किलो परेशन के चावल पीस करके आटा के साथ कौन पकड़ पाएंगे
ओके
पाओगे क्या
Okay. Gurudev is saying, I'll just come back. And Gurudev is saying about, nowadays in the market, they mix everything with cheaper things and sell you this like slowly, and you cannot realize it. So he's saying like the rice is so cheap. So this is only to get money, they do these things. Okay, so I'll just... Translate again the same part. So some people, what do they do? The business people, what do they do? They earn money, they get money. So do you know what they do? This happens so much. Okay, so like... So how much is the rice? How much is the rice? 3 rupees kilo.
वो चावल के लेकर थे, एक लोग कहते हैं बाजार में बेच देते हैं चावल को, 5 रुपए में खरीद लिया, मानो कि 10 रुपए के 5 रुपए खरीद लिया.
ओके, मे बी दे बॉट फॉर 5 रुपीस.
आटा के साथ गेहूं के साथ मिलाकर,
बट एनीवे दे मिक्स विद
आटा, कितने किलो
का फ्लावर,
20 रुपया किलो.
The rice, okay, so the atta, the wheat flour is 20 rupees the kilo. So they mix the rice flour in the middle of the wheat flour. Who can get, who can catch them, you know? Understood? So if you mix, with the wheat flour, rice flour, nobody will catch you. Nobody can even realize. So this is only to get money they do this. Because the rice flour, the rice was 5 rupees and they are selling mixed with this, mixed with the wheat flour, which is like 20 rupees, for example. So how much profit did they get? So actually, in India, black market, everything is like this, actually. So I think Gurudev is saying, sorry, I couldn't get exactly, but I think he was saying like that, like government knows there's all like black markets. They, you know, people do these things and they get some, you know, like they do some mafia something and then everything's okay. They, but then you say, oh, but I took diksha from the Gauri Amart. If I do the simple activities, so some people, they call the Vaishnavas and feed the Vaishnavas. Oh, like this, my sin will go away, be removed. So this is Namo Bole Pap Budi. You make the simple activities, so by the strength of chanting holy names. Because you know that by chanting holy names, your sin will be destroyed. So you're doing bad things and chanting holy names. So this will be one kind of offense. Then you cannot get welfare, you cannot not be good. So you have to chant without offenses, okay? So many people do this, many people. Okay, I got so much money. In Braj, before it was this Dharma Gata. So they said, oh, any percentage, some percentage of what you get of money, you have to give to the saints. I saw that all these businessmen, they created some community and they used to gather everyone's money and they used to use for the service of making a feast of prasadam in Giriraj, Govardhan, and also Kusum Sarovar. So they did some bandara. They made puri, you know. They made this. So, okay, they were making this a feast of prasadam, but what was it? Like puri and this too much chili in the sabji, like this. And they were people eating. So I told, okay, please don't call us from Gauri Amart. So many people, they do this. So there was this Dharma Ghata. I'm just coming back again in Vraj. So some percentage of what you get, you have to use to the saints, to serve the saints. So I saw. So these businessmen, they used to, they made some community like this, together people, their money. And they used to make some feast prasadam in Kusum Sarovar and Giriraj Govardhan. Feast prasadam, prasadam feast, feast. So they did the feast. So made the puri. I took maybe 2 or 4 puris and this pumpkin sabji, but full of chili. So I told, please don't call me, don't call us from Goriamata, just feed the other basado, it's okay. I don't know if this is still working nowadays, this kind of community. In the past, they were there. So all the business people, they used to get a little money from all the businessmen, you know, because they got the money from doing some simple activities. All these persons from shops, these business people, so they used to use some part of this money for sadhu seva. So, but no.
विष्णु कृतवान के शब्द के हमारे आचार्य जी लिख रहे हैं.
So the acharyas explain about Vishnu Krita means to follow, for example, Ekadashi also. Vishnu Krita, follow the festivals of Vishnu means follow Ekadashi. Those who don't follow Ekadashi or who don't follow Ram Navami, for example, or Gaura Purnima, Krishna Janmashtami. Some people in the Janmashtami before midnight they start eating rice. This offense. No. You have to follow the paran time. Cannot get anything with like the because you have to follow very nicely. Like you can only eat the rice after, you know, the paran time, the next day. So what is sadhu sangha? So Ajamil, he was listening to the conversation that happened amongst the Vishnu Dutas and Jamadutas. He was listening. So this is satsanga, association of sadhus. Like for example, you're here. I'm speaking. You may do some question in the middle or not. Maybe someone did question in the middle or not. But you're listening. This is called satsanga. Association of sadhu.
मम बीज संविदो भवन्ते हितकर्ण रसायन कथा तज्जोसनात् आसु अपवार्ग वर्त्मनि श्रद्धारुति भक्ति रनुक्रमेशति. श्रीमद् भागवत तृतीय स्कंद में.
So in third canto of Bhagavatam, this lok is there. Swayam Kapila Dev told his own mother. Oh mother.
मातो सुनिए.
Listen.
जहाँ जहाँ प्रसन्न महात्मा है.
Where the saints are. जाकर के. I go there and.
शक्तिशाली विजयवती कथा को जो है आप श्रवण करें.
Please listen my powerful katha from them.
मम वीर जो संग विदो भवन्ते हित कर्ण रसायन कथा. और कथा भी कैसे सुने.
And how to listen the Bhagavad katha.
आनंद देने वाली.
The katha gives bliss to the heart, you know, and to the ears also gives the bliss.
कथा को श्रवण करो.
Listen to this beautiful katha. This is satsanga, association of sadhu. So here we, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, is saying,
tumara naam suni hoy sapacho pavon alaukik shakti tumar na jaye kathan. Yahan par bhi pranam kare. श्रीविद्ध बालोगार चंडाल जवान सही तुम्हारे एक बार पाए दर्शन कृष्ण नाम लय जा लय नाचे होइया उद्मत्त आचार्य होइल सही तारिल जगत. भगवत दर्शन अथवा शुद्ध नाम श्रवण से बालक वृद्ध स्त्री वहां पर सब अत्यंत आनंद में नित्य आदि करने लगे. और इसी प्रकार हमारे अद्वैत आचार्य भगवत नाम देखकर
अद्वैत आचार्य उद्धार चंटिंग होली नेम्स एंड डिलीवर्स ऑल द लिविंग एंटिटीज.
नाम सुनी है सपच पावन अलौकिक शक्ति तुम्हारे ना जाए कथन. यहां पर करें
दर्शन. सो हियर सेइंग
दूर है जो कोई आपका नाम भी सुनता है वही कृष्ण प्रेम में मत्त होकर त्रिभुवन को तार देता है. आपके नाम के सुनकर कुत्ते के मांस खाने वाला भी.
By listening to your names, even the person who eats the dog meat of the dog becomes pure.
जद जिहाग्रे वर्तते नाम तुभ्यम अभुवत सह पच माने समाने कुत्ता पच माने कुत्ते
सा मींस डॉग एंड सपच मींस समवन करके समवन हु मेक्स द
खाने वाले
हु ईट्स द डॉग फ्लैश
हैं ऐसे कोई भी व्यक्ति भी एक बार प्रभु के नाम ले लेते हैं
if anyone chants once the holy names of god
sobacho to griyan wo shrestha mana jata hai
so this person is highest
brahman se bhi shrestha mana jata hai ek baar koi bhagwan ke naam lete hai
if once you chant holy names
sobacho sobacho to griyan jad yahagre vartate naam tubyam bole wo naam grahan karne wale vyakti ko kaise samajhna chahiye समझना चाहिए पूर्व जन्म में
सो इफ द पर्सन चेंटिंग होली नेम्स यू शुड नो दैट एक्चुअली
शास्त्र अध्ययन दान पुण्य सब कर चुके हैं
द पर्सन हैज ऑलरेडी गिविंग डोनेशन ही डिड एवरीथिंग ऑलरेडी गुड इन द प्रीवियस लाइफ दैट्स व्हाई दिस पर्सन चेंटिंग होली नेम्स नाउ
तनमो के हरि नाम तिष्ठन्ति भारत हो संग भगवान अर्जुन के कहने लगे अर्जुन आदि पुराण में कथा है अर्जुन
सो एक्चुअली भगवान कृष्ण टोल्ड टू अर्जुन इन द आदि पुराण Listen, Arjun, who will sing my name? Those in 100 lives, in 100 lives, they already worship the deity of Vasudev. Okay? Only these people will be able to chant holy names. The sinful people will not chant my holy names. So Ratnakar, you know, the original name of Valmiki was Ratnakar. He was a thief. He used to do so much sinful activities. Nandarishi told him, chant holy names of Ram, but he couldn't chant. Even a simple name as Ram. Okay, for Krishna, name of Krishna, you have to bend your tongue. Vishnu, Krishna. You have to turn your tongue three times. But Ram is so simple and straight. Rama, very easy. Chant the name of Ram. Oh, I can't. Okay, so chant the opposite. Oh, you see this tree? This tree is dead. Mara. Okay, so sing this name. Mara, 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 Mara. So Tulasidas wrote what? That, you know, Valmiki was singing the opposite names of Ram and he got benefits. You can sing like Mara 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 Mara. It will become the name of Ram, isn't it? So those who chant holy names, they are so pure. You don't know your own glories. Who will tell you your own glories, isn't it? Those who are higher than you, they can tell you your glories. So look, they are chanting holy names. This is true. But there's one rule. What? If once you chant holy names, early in the morning after waking up, as soon as you wake up, understood? Everybody listen very carefully. Open your ears and listen. Just after you open your eyes, after you wake up, just start chanting. Immediately. Chant holy names.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
So chant holy names.
पवित्र हो अपवित्र
यू मे बी प्योर और इम्प्योर
कोई विचार नहीं
नो प्लान देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम ओके अजामिल ही हैड डेफिकेटेड एंड यूरिनेटेड इन दैट कंडीशन ही चेंट द नेम ऑफ नारायण Oh no, first I'll go to the bathroom, I'll wash my hands, my feet, I will take shower, I'll do achaman, I will do... No, and then I'll chant holy names. No, what if you die before that? Or if something happens before that? No, no, no. So I tell to everyone, you must chant. When you sleep, you just put put next to your head, your japamala, just next to your head, you know, your head. Where? You have to place your japamala just in the next to your head, in the on the bed, you know, near your bed, head of your bed, like this. So just wake up and first thing you touch your japamala and just start chanting.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Naam karo. Ananda.
This bliss will come if you chant holy names. And then after that, okay, maybe for 2-5 minutes, then okay, like how much time you have, you do chant. And then okay, then you take your water. After taking water, then you have to clear your stomach. So then you go to the bathroom. So I tell you, so after chant the holy names, after wake up, you chant holy names, like 2-5 minutes, chant holy names, and then drink 2 glasses of water. And then you see that your belly will be clean. So after drinking the water, you need to clear your stomach, your intestine. So okay, for 2-5 minutes, chant holy names when you wake up, and then drink 2 glasses of water. And then you'll see that your belly will be clean, you know, intestine. So before drinking the water, check if there's anyone in the bathroom. Otherwise, it will be difficult to contain. Because after drinking the water, you need to go to the bathroom immediately. This is true. You can practice and do that and you'll see. I do this. For long years, many years I do this. I do this. So I chant holy names. So if I see there is someone in the bathroom, I don't drink water. I continue chanting. But if the bathroom is free, then I drink 2-3 glasses of water and then I go to the bathroom. But if I drink the water and the person is still in the bathroom, then I have to go to the other bathroom, the other one there. So this is true. This is true for your body. This is true. Then you'll not be sick. Your body will be clear and also your... So that's why early in the morning you have to chant holy names. So you'll not be sick, your body will be heavy, so your it's good, like you chant holy names and also your body is also good for your body. So early in the morning you have to chant holy names. How much rounds you can chant, no problem, in the morning, maybe 2 rounds or 4 rounds, how much you can. But Gurudev used to say, if you chant holy names in the Brahma Muhurta, all the holy names that you chant, look, all the other holy names you chant during the day, actually if you chant in the Brahma Muhurta time, you get 4 times more benefit than whatever holy names you chant in the rest of the day. 4 times more benefit the name you chant in the Brahma Muhurta time. Why? Shastra says that, listen very carefully, you know, the day and night, they are shared in the, you know, divided in the time of goodness, passion and ignorance, isn't it? But the Brahma Muhurta, before sun rising, 1 hour 36 minutes, it's called Brahma Muhurta. This is a time of satik, a mode of goodness. The mind is so calm and fixed. You can chant holy names. Your mind will automatically want to chant holy names in this moment, because the mode of goodness.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
But then after sun rises, then starts the mode of passion. Oh, I need to do this, I need to go to the office, I need to do this, I need to do that. So this is mode of passion. And after sunset, you know, then starts the mode of ignorance. The sleepiness come, fear, all this is tamasic. mode of ignorance.
इसलिए
So that's why early in the morning, in the Brahma Muhurta time, you have to wake up and everybody should chant holy names.
बाकी सब कुछ काम रहे, कुछ पढ़ा तो है। भाई पांच फेरा हरि नाम कर दे, 25 फेरा हरि नाम के बराबर हो जाएगा। है? आप पांच जो राउंड जो
If you chant five rounds in the Muhurta, five rounds in the Brahma Muhurta,
जो और बाकी जो 25 है कि बराबर हो जाएगा।
Okay, look. If you chant five rounds in the Brahma Muhurta, it is equal of chanting 25 rounds during your day. Did you understand? Five rounds in Brahma Muhurta equals to 25 rounds during the day. Because your mind is so into Harinam. Like your mind is not going anywhere, it's only in the Harinam at that time. Understand? However, you chant, Mahaprabhu told. Mahaprabhu. So you can chant as standing, walking, sitting. However, just chant holy names. Chant holy names.
नियम तो ही है so, एक स्थान पर एक आसन पर बैठकर
का so the rule is okay it's good to chant in one place and sit the highest instruction is to sit on the same place and like a concentrate in one asana you sit down and chant the names in the sitting in one place but maybe you feel pain in your leg or here and there so you can also chant walking no problem
यदि आपके बैठने भी दर्द हो
if you have pain back like if you sit down you can also chant holy names lying you know lying down no problem just chant
aur bhagwan ke naam mein koi sab ye nahi prithak nahi alag nahi hai
there is no difference between holy names and gods god gave all his potency where into holy names and holy names is higher than shri hari
dekho isliye isse bada kya prat kal mein uthke naam
so early in the morning just wake up and chant holy names
isliye brahma muhurt mein
So early in the morning, wake up and chant holy names. Try to do this. If you put tilaka or not, so wash your mouth or not, wash your hand, legs or not, no problem. There's no problem. Holy names will make you pure. Holy names will make you poor. Okay, then you get ready. Then you be pure. Like you take your shower, bath, and then do a Gayatri mantra like this. So Mahaprabhu said.
भगवान के नाम ग्रहण करने की कोई नियम नहीं रखा गया
There's no any rule for chanting holy names. You can do in the daytime, the night time, midday you can chant holy names, in midnight you can chant. However, but for mantras there are many rules. Before sunrise you have to chant your mantras. The Gayatri mantras have to chant before sunrise.
और विधि में तो है नियम
many other rules are also there other rules but to chant holy names eating sleeping walking speaking just chant
वैकुंठ नाम ग्रहणं असिसागरं विदुति अशेष अघमने पाप
Aga means the sins will be destroyed if you chant holy names. Especially in Kali Yuga, Bhagavan, he put all his potency in the holy names. Because in Kali Yuga, people cannot do anything in this Kali Yuga, you know. Can you do something here? No. You don't even have time for listening to Harikatha. You feel so much back. Then you have to, three times you have to change position like this. But, For chanting holy names, no. So this is the glories of the holy names. Whatever the Bhagavatam explains, the Bhagavatam starts in Nam Sankirtan, the Bhagavatam, in the middle of Bhagavatam also, glorifies the glories of the holy names. Because sixth canto, Ajamil Katha is in the sixth canto. So the Bhagavatam has 12 cantos, you know. So in the first canto, he's explaining the glories of the holy names. सत्यं परम धीमहि आई मेडिटेट इन द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रुथ
सत्यं परम धीमहि ये परम शब्द
सो परम
भगवान के नाम की महिमा
इज द एक्चुअली द ग्लोरीज ऑफ होली नेम्स हु इज द परम सत्य स्वरूप द हाईएस्ट एब्सोल्यूट ट्रुथ
मेरे गुरुदेव कहते हैं
कृष्ण
एक लौकिक सत्य और पारमार्थिक सत्य लौकिक सत्य क्या है जो हाथ में जो आता है ना उसी कहा जाता है
Lokik sata means temporary truth. It's, for example, what comes in your hands. If you say, Maharaj, I'll give you 10 rupees. Maybe you didn't give yet. And then you die before giving me the money. So you told that you're going to give the money, but you didn't give. So this didn't happen. So this didn't become true. Isn't it? So this will become really true? Like Lokik Sata. Lokik Sata means like this Myunjan truth. My Gurudev used to say. So whatever I get in my hands, this is truth. Like Lokik Sata, this Myunjan, like worldly truth, is what comes in my hand. You know, because maybe the person says he'll give the money, but maybe he dies before giving the money, for example. So this is not true, only the words. So truth is what comes in my hand, like worldly truth. Lokik Sata, my Gurudev used to say. But Paramarthik Sata, like spiritual truth, is the holy names of God, Bhagavad Nam.
Satam Param Dhimahi. O Satta Vastu Param Vastu. Bhagavat Saksat Bhagavat Sarup. Usi ke dhyan karo.
So I meditate. In this. God.
Naam ki mahima sabhi sabhi. Aur naam rasa sarup hai. Naam Krishna.
Holy names, the rasa sarupa. So in the first slok of Bhagavatam, everything is there. What about the glories of the holy names, glories of rasa, glories of Bhagavan, in this own first slok of Bhagavatam. So janma adi asya means the creation, maintenance, destruction, everything comes from him.
ये किसके कौन करते हैं? भगवान करते जन्मादश है और फिर जन्मादश अश यही श्रीमद् भागवत में इसी श्लोक में अश माने इसी श्लोक में
अश मींस इन दिस श्लोक ऑफ द भागवतम
ना श्रृंगार रस की महिमा बता
एक्चुअली एक्सप्लेन द ग्लोरीज ऑफ श्रृंगार रस
आदि रस
आदि रस मींस द ओरिजिनल रस
आदि रस के आदि शब्द के अर्थ होते
हैं आदि मींस उत्पत्ति का सुकार उत्पत्ति मींस द सोर्स ऑफ ऑल द रसस
एक अनेक सिनोनिम होते हैं ना
मेनी सिम्पटम्स मेनी मीनिंग्स
इस समस्त रस की उत्पत्ति क्या है आदि रस कहा जाता है
सो द
क्या है श्रृंगार रस जिसको माधुर्य रस कहा जाता है
माधुर्य रस श्रृंगार रस इज द सोर्स ऑफ ऑल द रसस सो दिस आदि रस
माधुर्य श्रृंगार
सो दिस पराकीय माधुर्य श्रृंगार रस दिस द ओरिजिनल रस है
अन्य और व्यतिरिक रूप में साक्षात रूप में अथवा इनडायरेक्ट और आइडेंट सारे तत्व की वर्णन करा दिया
सो डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली ऑल दिस तत्व इज देयर
सब इसमें वर्णन है इसलिए जन्मादश्च जत अन्य आदि त्रतश्च अभिज्ञ सराट वो स्वयं सराट पुरुष है स्वयं भगवान
और स्वयं भगवान
किसका जो अपने
सराट मींस
भाव में सर्व सर्वदा स्थित रहते हैं
who is always absorbed in his
अर्थ होता है
own भाव
अपना
रात means स्वरात he's always fixed in his own भाव he doesn't change like he's not moving he's fixed in his भाव
हिमालय पर्वत
just like a big Himalaya mountain
हिमालय पर्वत के यदि समुद्र में
If you put a big Himalaya mountain inside the ocean, the Himalaya mountain will continue there, like fixed. You'll not change, like not move. So you can see, like sometimes great mountains in the ocean. You know, the great waves of the ocean, they come and hit this mountain, clash in the mountain. But the mountain doesn't move, nothing happens to the mountain. So in the same way, Bhagavan, he's always fixed.
अनेक अर्थ है
many meanings
एक ही
श्लोक so स्वरात many means so in one verse कितने अर्थ बताए how many meanings the acharyas explained from this only the first verse of bhagavatam tata vichar rasa vichar
प्रकार विचार करके दिखा दिया उनके 25 प्रकार के अर्थ दिखाए
at least 25 meanings in the first श्लोक of bhagavatam
इसे जन्मादस्य जत अन्न आदि तरतस्य विद स्वरात अन्नय व्यतिरेक रूप में माने
अन्नय means indirectly
और मिलन
means actually
मिलन
Anaya means
biraha.
No, sorry, not indirectly. He said, like in the two ways, meeting and separation. So in the two moments.
फिर परम सत्त, है वो परम सत्त, है
So if you, it will take 7 days to describe only the first shloka of the Bhagavatam. This will be the Bhagavad Sapta, no need to do anything else. Oh, Maharaj, but you're not telling me the katha of Dhruva Maharaj, of Ajamil? No, but actually everything is in the first canto, first shloka. First shloka of Bhagavatam. If you memorize two shlokas of Bhagavatam, everything is there in these two shlokas. So like this, Jayate Janani Vaso, Devaki Janma Vado, this is one of them. In this shloka also, everything is there. All the Bhagavatam is in this shloka in a nutshell. So two shlokas of the Bhagavatam, everything of the Bhagavatam is inside these two shlokas. One is the first shloka.
Janani.
And then another one, so the first shloka of Bhagavatam, and another one is, I just spoke. Jayati Janani Vaso. In this other shloka also. All Bhagavatam is there. So you can see the commentary of Vishwanatha Chakravarti Pada. And also the first shloka, this commentary. So the first canto of the Bhagavatam until the 10th canto. I mean, everything is in these two slokas, okay? So the Bhagavatam started with the Nama Sankirtan. So in the beginning, in the middle, in the end, only Nama Sankirtan. You can do any. So whatever good activity it is you do in Kali Yuga, you have to start with Nama Sankirtan, in the middle of Nama Sankirtan, and also in the end of Nama Sankirtan. You must finish with Nama Sankirtan. The last shloka of the Bhagavatam also explains about Nama Sankirtan. So in the verse Janmadasa Jataha, the first explains about the glory of holy names. Middle is also a story of Ajamil. And also in the end, last shloka of Bhagavatam also explains the glory of holy names. Because in Kali Yuga, you don't need to do anything else. Like, why we speak Harikatha and we gather so many people just so that people can start have taste in chanting holy names. But not dry holy names, sukha holy names, but rasa jukta holy names, like with rasa, with holy names with this flavor, sweet juice. Like for example, sugar candy is sweet, but it's hard, you know, sugar candy. But rasa gulla, like a sponge or rubbery, like condensed milk. This is sweet. Okay, what sweet we want? Like sugar candy? Sugar candy? If you take a sugar candy, maybe your teeth will break. Those who have, you know, weak teeth, if they eat sugar candy, their teeth will be broke. But if you eat sugar, rasgulla or rubri, condensed milk, not natural, it will be so delicious, isn't it? So only one meaning that, so just for one reason that we are chanting holy names and I mean for, we are speaking katha just so that we'll be able to develop this taste in chanting holy names. So what I want to say is, holy names is rasa swarupa. Everything is in the holy names. So why we speak all this katha of Bhagavatam? Why we listen to the Bhagavatam? For one reason. How can we develop taste in holy names? But which kind of holy names? Taste in these names full of rasa madhurya and like this. So sweet, so beautiful. Bhagavatam is the form of holy names. Rasa Swarupa also. So why we arrange this Bhagavad Katha, everything? Not so just to gather people or get people like this. Actually, just that for 7 days, like in a vow, we can just sit down and listen Hari Katha. Because when you go to Jamaloka, they'll ask you, have you heard any Bhagavad Katha? No? Okay, put this in one side. He didn't listen any Bhagavad Katha. They'll ask you, have you listened Bhagavad? Yes. Okay, so come to this. Come to this side who listened Bhagavad Katha, and who didn't listen, go to the other side. So they also have rules in the Jamalok, in the hell. They'll ask you, have you heard any Bhagavad Katha in your life? Yes. What have you heard? But so you have to tell them a story of the Bhagavatam. Because some people lie, you know. So, because this person will see like, oh, those who listen the Bhagavatam, they are going to a different place. So if somebody asks him in the hell, have you heard the Bhagavatam? This person will say, oh, yes, yes, I heard. But actually he's lying. So what will happen is that, okay, I'll tell you one story. Akbar Badsha, the emperor, told to Birbal, his minister, Birbal, listen, people of this world, people say they are controlled by the wives, the ladies, because of lust. Even great saints, they are controlled by lust. Even you see Vishwamitra, like great personalities, even Shiva, everybody's, you know, controlled by lust and like a... So everyone in this world is controlled by the ladies, by the wives. I'm not saying about this your devotees. No, I'm not saying by those who chant holy names. I'm talking about normal ladies. So don't think you're these ladies I'm talking about. Because you do Bhagavad Bhajan is different, but like general men, they are controlled by lust because of these normal ladies, these general ladies. So the emperor, Akbar Badshah, said, oh, I heard that everyone in this world is controlled by ladies because of lust. But this emperor said, the minister agreed, yes, Maharaj, it's true. But the king said, oh, I can't believe. Maybe, so don't think I'm talking about you. I'm talking about general people, okay? So the king said, but I don't believe. I think at least one or two persons, maybe they are different. They are not completely controlled by women. So don't think I'm talking about you and your wife. No, no, because then you come back to your house and it'll be a great quarrel, isn't it? If you think, I'm not talking about you. I'm just want to make clear, okay? So... Okay, but I don't believe the Maharaj, the king said. So the minister said, okay, do one thing. Call 100 persons tomorrow. 100 people tomorrow you call. Married people. Okay, married people. Call 100 tomorrow. So they call 100 people. So they put some chairs in one side and also in the other side. So there were 100 chairs kept. There were 100 chairs in the right side and 100 chairs in the left side. Then it was written, those who are not controlled by your wives sit in the right side. And those who are controlled by the wives sit in the left side. But be truthful, like be honest. Some people... Oh, okay, so... 99% of the people, they sat in which side? The left side, which means those who are completely controlled by the ladies. Okay, I do whatever my wife says. One person only was sitting in the other side. So the emperor said, oh, Birbal, oh, minister, you told that all 100 people, like 100% was controlled by the wives, but you see, one person is not controlled. Then the minister told, ask him why is he sitting in another place? Why? Ask him. Ask him if he's controlled by his wife or not. Then Akbar Badshah, emperor, ask this man, why are you sitting in this side? You're not controlled by your wife? Then he told, oh Maharaj, what can I say? When I was coming, I left my house, I was coming here, huh? Then my wife told me, okay, You see, when the majority of the persons is one place, never go where the majority is. My wife always told me, never go where the majority is. The man told. So my wife told me, she gave me order to always be in the opposite side. Like, don't go to where the majority are. So you know, like the majority of people is here. So I want to be in the other side. No, now coronavirus, you want to be not in the crowded place like this. So this material world. But chanting holy name slowly, slowly, in our hearts, this lust, anger, everything will go away. Especially these glories of holy names, I'm saying. In the beginning, the middle, in the end. Chant holy names, always. So this is the words of Shastra. Bhagavatam explains about the glories of Nam Sankirtan. In the beginning, Bhagavatam, in the middle also, of the Bhagavatam also explains the glory of holy names, and in the end also of Bhagavatam. So in Kali Yuga, there's nothing else. So why we're gathering people to do the Bhagavad Sapta and everything in the month of Purushottam? Why? Because we have to remember all these things, otherwise we forget. We forgot the Bhagavad Gata. So we call the people, we gather everyone together. Just like when you have some festival in your house, you call all your friends, you gather everyone. This is one kind of festival, Utsav. What is a festival, Utsav?
It's
when you call all your friends and you distribute some prasadam. This is Utsav festival. So the Bhagavad Katha is like a festival. Otherwise, you don't even know where is your good brothers, where are your good sisters, who took diksha from whom. Oh, he went to that guru, to the other guru, to that guru. You don't even know. You don't even know about Guru Tata, nothing. So no. So that's why you gather together to make us remember. To remember ourselves and to make others remember. Like the Bhagavatam explains. What is Utsava festival? We gather together, everyone. Understand. Even the ministers also, they gather together. Why? The other day I was telling that story. That Prime Minister of Uttar Pradesh, one state of India, he was telling, I was just listening. Sometimes comes in YouTube also. So all the kings from India, they were gathered, all the ministers, like a governors of India, they were gathered, and they have different languages, because, you know, in India, they have different languages, in different places, you know, Hindi language, Odia language, many different kinds of language. So language is very difficult place, different place. So India is such a diversified country, so many people from different languages and everything. Understand? So this minister was saying, this governor was saying, so all the ministers which gathered there, so they, we didn't know each other so much. So I was asking, oh, where are you from? Like this. So we meet together and then we meet each other. Then we get to know who we are, like each other. Who are you? Oh, he's the governor of the Bengal. This is the minister, governor of this other states, governor of the other states. So even these people from high positions, they are saying, also we don't know each other. So we have to gather together and know. So that's all, they gather together like this. So in the same way, we're giving this example. We call everyone to do the Bhagavad Katha so that everybody will come. Everybody will come together and Oh, what are you doing? Oh, you should chant holy names. And also you preach to others. Those who don't do, also they must know, you have to tell them. So this festival. And also the prashad is given to everyone. Isn't it? So this will be so much blissful, bliss to everyone. Bhagavatam explains. What was the festival for the gopis? To see Krishna was the festival for the gopis. So the gopis were happy, blissful in the festival of bliss just to see Krishna with their eyes.
दर्शन करने के लिए गोपियां कैसे उद्दीप बढ़ाते रहते हैं उसमें भागवत में लिखा है
भागवत एक्सप्लेन्स
ये भी उत्सव मनाते हैं
सो दे आर सेलिब्रेटिंग द फेस्टिवल जस्ट बाय सिंग टू कृष्णा
अटति जाद भवान अन्निकाननं त्रुटि जुगायते ताम पश्यताम कुटिल कुंतलं श्री मुखंचते जड़ उदृच्छत्वां पक्षति दृशम गोपी गीत आ रहे ना
Gopi Gita explains, when Krishna was grazing the cows and coming back from the grazing, all the gopis, they were making a festival, like a party, just to see Krishna. All the gopas and gopis, all the cows, they were coming together and celebrating a festival. Govinda Darshan festival means just a festival to see Krishna. And also the associates of Krishna, they are also seeing all the associates. Just like example, for example, you came, your mother came, your friends come, your sister came, your son came, everybody came. Then the festival, everyone meets together. Just like in the weddings, everybody come. But in the Bhagavatam, everybody comes and is friends, everyone. Gurudev is already live doing the reading of Chaitanya Charitamrita. I'm almost finished here. Okay, so gopis were so happy to see Krishna. And they were also having the darshan of all the associates. Just like here, you come, your sister comes, your brother comes, your friends come, your son comes. In the festival, I think Gurudev is saying, okay, maybe not in the wedding, sometimes you don't call, maybe some people don't call everyone, because maybe spending so much money, like different people. So not maybe not call everyone, like all the people to the to your wedding, but okay, maybe call depends, but in the Bhagavatam, everybody comes. Everybody, like friendship with each other and comes to the Bhagavatam, everybody. Just like when Krishna was returning from the cow grazing or going to the cow grazing, all the gopis, with their lotus eyes, gopis were making a festival. With their eyes for seeing Krishna, not only seeing Krishna, because they were seeing also all the parikaras of Krishna also at the same time. Do you understand? Like Radha, Lalita, Vishakha, Subhas, Sridham, everyone, Mridangamukhi, all the cows, Shyamali, Davali, all of them, all the cows. They were like walking, all the cows coming with Krishna. Such a big sound coming and such a big, beautiful festival, everyone together. So what you're, so everybody is living in different place like this, but when you meet together, it's such blissful, bliss, so much bliss. That's why sometimes we should also, there must be this Bhagavad Katamritam and everybody meets together at least two or three times in the year. Two times must have this Bhagavad Kata in the year, but otherwise you forget. Three, four times is good, it's bad, but at least two times must be there, Bhagavad Kata in the year. Okay, now we are following Purushottam Vrat, okay?
इसके अलावा करना चाहिए कम से कम साल में
but in the year should have at least
दो बार
two times
कथा होनी चाहिए
the kata and everybody can gather together
आज समझ में नहीं है
understand
कथा को आनंद आ जाएगा
then bliss will come So don't give money, I say. Don't even give money. Just take prasada for 7 days. Everything's arranged.
दान करना है दान करो नहीं तो दान
If you want to give donation give If God gave when you want to give okay but if you cannot give or don't want just don't give just come and take prasadam So don't ask to anyone if they gave money or how much they gave or not just take prasada for 7 days I give guarantee For 7 days All the prasada is arranged for you so like just relax and take prasada if you want to give give it otherwise don't give no problem at all But everybody must take prasad. So you should not ask, oh, you didn't give money, so go and stand in the line, end of the line. And no. My Gurudev used to say, Shri Narayan Goswami Maharaj said, even if a dog comes to my temple, he should not go empty-handed. He has to take prasad. So what have I come in this world to take? I'll not take anything with me also when I go from this world. Any 2 seconds, I can just die here. And finish. So that's why there's no any lack of money. So many people giving money, but maybe not so much people to take prasada. So just call everyone and take prasada. Listen Bhagavad Gata and take prasada, everyone. You can see just like in the day of Janmashtami, they distribute so much puris, so many people puri and sabji from morning time to the evening time, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Maybe this year because of coronavirus they didn't do this, but generally they do so much. So there are people to give money, people also take prasada, no problem. So I invite everyone, come, call to everyone. All come to katha and take prasada. So if you have a tulsi leaf, you can also give a tulsi leaf. I am a saint, okay, no problem, but take prasada. So today is Ekadashi. Okay, but now you not get prasadam still because Ekadashi, but Ekadashi prasada later.
बोलो वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय जय श्री राम हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे कहाँ गए मनुष्य